Hello and welcome to Export Digest, your number one program that periscopes Nigeria's non-oil sector. On Export Digest, we bring you information that helps you see economic possibilities in non-oil export, a sector we strongly believe is Nigeria's alternative source of foreign exchange earnings. On the program, we highlight several opportunities and explore strategies to exploit these opportunities as we seek to identify and propose solutions to challenges in the sector. Our goal is to enable practitioners and policy makers improve on their respective roles as it relates to export business. My name is Mayoko Apoterabo. Non-oil exports remains Nigeria's alternative source of foreign exchange. You also can be a big player by knowing how and what it takes to engage in profitable non-oil export business. Export Digest features experts with local and global knowledge of non-oil export business, presenting you with everything you ever need to know. Non-oil items you can export, important tips on export packaging, export documentation and regulatory standards, logistics and transportation issues from farm gate to the port and then destination country, export funding and available markets for different commodities, products and services. Don't miss Export Digest, showing on Core TV Mondays at 8 p.m. with a repeat broadcast Wednesdays at 12:30 p.m. Export Digest, promoting Nigeria's non-oil export sector. The thrust of Export Digest this quarter is tracking export support in Nigeria. The objective is to nudge policymakers in the direction of providing adequate support that makes for a viable non-oil export sector. Providing the support needed will mean formulating policies or activating the dormant ones, providing support instruments such as incentives, and strengthening the relevant institutions to ensure an effective, efficient, and productive sector. Today, we will take a look at creating a new basket of incentives for non-oil export.
My name is Ken Okaha, the president of the National Association of Nigerian Traders, NANTS.
I have Obinaya C. Uruapa, personal development trainer, public affairs analyst, and an entrepreneur.
Keep watching
Export Digest.
Export Digest.
Don't change the dial.
Efforts have been made by the Nigerian government over the years in the area of providing incentives for non-oil exports. Olufemi Boyede, a certified international trade professional and the MD CEO of Koinonia Ventures Limited, chronicles past efforts and offer insight into what can be done to incentivize non-oil exports.
The talk about creating a new basket of incentives for Nigeria exports did not just start today. As far back as year 2007, a presidential review committee on waivers, concessions and incentives under the chairmanship of the current Minister of National Planning, Senator Udoma Udoma, actually looked at the possibility of harmonizing all incentives in Nigeria, whether they be trade incentives, technical, agricultural. Recommendation of that committee was the fact that for Nigeria products and Nigeria to be competitive in the international market, we just must not only stick with incentives but actually ensure adequacy of them and smooth implementation. Of course, just like we said in the last episode, it looks like Nigeria has spent too much time actually concentrating only on the export expansion grant. We take the example for again from maybe from the starting from the Africa continent. South Africa, knowing fully well that its priority for foreign exchange generation depends on the ability of its various sectors to penetrate and remain in the export market, has about 34 different export promotion councils. We have only one. Rather than go general, it is probably better that we even begin to develop sector-specific export incentives. The export expansion grant is general. It has been recategorized into raw commodities, agricultural commodities, semi-manufactured and fully manufactured products. But part of the problem that the EEG has had over the years is the ability to actually distinguish what is a semi-finished product and what is a fully finished product, who should qualify for the highest rate and who should qualify for the intermediate rate. All this is happening because, of course, it is like a one-cap-fits-all kind of incentive that we have. But we should understand that the challenges that handicraft exports face, for example, is not the same challenge that smelting of scrap metal to produce steel and aluminium ingots for export. They are not the same thing. The problem that a cocoa processing factory faces is not the same the problem that a textile factory, a textile mill is facing. Tower aluminium products have their own challenges, and so have. So it is probably the time now for us to prioritize our exports. I am sure that the NEPC Zero Oil Plan talked about 13 products. Hopefully, the amended version or the revised version will also take into consideration services exports. But what I'm saying, for example, even the 13 products or whatever products that we have right now, we only have EEG addressing them. What happens to services? Because I still remain convinced that if Nigeria were able to mainstream the services sector, services export sector into its economy, we will not be in recession. You recall that last time that Nigeria's economy was rebased, services bailed out the economy, not only bailed out, put us as the largest economy in Africa. That's services. Now, we're services in general. Now, imagine a situation where we are able to enter the committee of global nations that are getting wealth from services export, at least for whom services export is being captured as international trade.
Practitioners believe that a lot of support is needed to trigger the interest of more Nigerian businesses in the line of non-oil export.
We need to prioritize. We need to do sector-specific export incentives. We must find also industry-level specific. And that's where the example of Australia, for example, comes in. Australia has a different set of incentives that allows or that triggers your interest in the export activity. We've spent so much time. This is the second or third year that Export Digest has been running on NTA News 24. This year it started running on Core TV Pari Passu with NTA News 24. There must be millions of you out there who are getting charged, attracted to the export activity, but who are handicapped in one way or the other for export readiness. So Australia has a different set of incentives for startup and potential startup exporters. That is called the new exporter development incentives. That's what Export Development Fund is supposed to be doing for Nigeria. So that, I think I made that illustration here before. SMEDAN, the Small Medium Enterprises Development Agency of Nigeria, spends millions training thousands of new entrepreneurs every year in Nigeria. How many of them go into the export trade? Very, very few, because they do not have export readiness capacity. Where is the incentive that allows them to get properly trained? Where is the fund? Which fund have we set up that enables them to actually attend trade fora, apart from the trade exhibitions that NEPC helps them, and very, very few of them to attend? Imagine what is the financial capacity of Export Promotion Council How many trade fairs do they attend in a year? If we have a country of 180 million, let's even assume that just 10% of these are interested to engage seriously in export activity. They can even take 1% of these 18 to actually prepare them and make them export ready. Those are the challenges. We should be talking about strengthening the trade support institutions themselves, and then looking at export level and industry level incentives that allow us to be able to produce and support these export activities that we're talking about.
Nigeria can also harness the opportunities provided by different international institutions to develop non-oil export.
We have development partners who come into Nigeria once in a while, carrying a basket of funds with them, saying that they are seeking which sector to support. Until the Nigerian government makes export a priority, development partners are not going to continue to allocate. They will not. It's based on your request. And I remember, with all due modesty, I was one of those in the year 2002 or thereabout who insisted at UN level, at ITC level, that thenceforth trade support, international trade support funding, must be demand driven. So if it is demand driven, which of these agencies do we have a project strategy that we, a project document that we are going to, this is how we develop our export. DFID is still there. You see, I think is winding up now, but I'm sure that another new project is going to come up. The European Union Center for Enterprise Development, they are still there. They are going to want of support. UNIDO is there. Supporting quality infrastructure. So how do we position to get all of this in order to create the new basket of incentives?
So how do we position Nigeria to take advantage of available support from international institutions as we look to creating this new basket of incentives?
In developing the new basket of incentives, we have to think inter-ministry. It has to be an inter-agency collaboration. It just must be. We are aware that the Nigeria Export Promotion Council actually spearheaded a series of meetings in the past few months, talking about the creation of a new basket of incentives for Nigeria. Export Digest is going a step further to look at actually what each of these agencies is supposed to bring in as its own demand. And I think it must be in the 2005 EEG guidelines. I think the last provision, the last clause in that guideline was that from then onwards, from 2005 onwards, Nigeria exporters would not be allowed to double dip. Double dipping at that time meant that once you are earning EEG, you cannot go to any other place to go and apply for incentive. We need to increase our sensitization and public education and awareness on the export sector itself. People must be helped to understand what this export chain is all about. To use the word of some of our viewers who send us email, I want to understand this export thing itself. It's a very large subject to understand. So we need to revisit that. We need to activate the Export Development Fund. People must be able to understand or to know where to go to if they need to do market research, if they need to do supply-based study. And for that matter, even the Nigeria Export Promotion Council itself does need to do to update the supply-based study that it did a few years ago so that people are able to understand. These days we talk about mapping. It just has to be done, and it has to be done on a very, very extensive level. That's why I talk about strengthening the institutions. Of course, it means that the National Agency for the Promotion of Export needs to have adequate funding support and also intellectual support to carry out that kind of activity. You go to the financing sector, Nexim, Bank of Industry, what funds are available for them that they can dedicate to export activity? Go to the commercial banks. How many commercial banks in Nigeria have the expertise to provide export development advice even to their own customers? And in this case, I'm not asking government to help the banks to do that. I am thinking that it is time that Nigerian banks themselves started to think export, to prepare the export sector so that they can get a new, again, let me use the word basket, a new basket of customers who are only going to earn foreign exchange for themselves. Our export desk, the export desk of Nigeria's commercial banks are very, very, very weak. That's the truth. So you need to look at it again from that level. We need to understand that the issue of rejection of Nigeria's export products actually starts from the production, from the cultivation, from the farm itself. The world has gone organic. What are our agricultural practices? And this is where the interagency collaboration must come in, because the Ministry of Agriculture, for example, needs to factor in export development into every single strategy that they are coming in. Agricultural transformation agenda must carry into it an export component that targets what farmers should be doing.
Let us identify potential challenges and give insight into how they can be addressed. These are steps that must be taken to create the new basket of incentives and make it an efficient support instrument for non-oil export.
Export support means being able to also bring out the product that you have produced, you have cultivated, or you have processed, to bring it out in a competitive international packaging and labeling. Nigeria is still deficient in the area of packaging and labeling for exports. So this is an area that is deserving of more than just a look in from government when you are talking about export support.
The role of government is strategic. The onus is really on the government to actually create the enabling environment for private sector involvement, or what you may call a public-private partnership, to improve support for the non-oil export sector.
If government does not have the fund, government can help to develop the feasibility studies for each of these aspects of the logistics value chain to support export that will allow private sector, private investor. For example, if we are talking about laboratories, in addition to what UNIDO and SUN are doing, is it not a sector that private sector investment can come in? Let's provide the environment. If we are talking about labeling, even translation, if we are targeting the Chinese market, how do we translate the product information into Chinese? Certification, whether it is organic or not organic, whether it is bio-organic or whether it is whatever standardizations that are necessary, we must this up. That is where we shall be talking. We shall then be proud to say that we are, as a nation, providing ample support for export. We are not there yet.
To enable Nigerians optimize the benefits from the country's vast agricultural products such as cassava, oil palm, rice, tomatoes and others, the Bank of Industry has launched a 5 billion naira cottage agro-processing fund, the CAP Fund. Customers can access the fund to establish plans to process our various agro-produce into food products or intermediate raw materials for industries at a single-digit interest rate of 9% per annum. For more information on the CAP Fund, please visit www.boinigeria.com/CAP Fund. Bank of Industry, developing Nigeria's agro-processing industry through the CAP Fund.
Let's hear from the Corporate Affairs Commission.
An incorporated trustee is basically the registration of a set of trusts that will take care of non-charitable organizations, clubs, you know, basically human relations. It has nothing to do with business. That's where it is different. The business arm of registration in Corporate Affairs Commission actually covers the part A and the part B. Part C has to do with human interests. That is people who share the same kind of interests coming together to register an association or an organization to take care of that interest. That is for free. They are not going to make money out of it, but they want to offer their services. But in the course of it, the issue of money also comes in, because there may be donations from international organizations, from well-meaning Nigerians and so on, and that's where the issue of money comes into it. Otherwise, it's not a business. It's not a business where you say you are looking for profit and that you make the profit. No, any money that comes into this organization is used in taking care of these human interests. There must be that common interest to which the people want to associate. You understand? They must have a common ground that they have an interest in, and they want to register that. It can be a family. It can be a religious body. It can be tribal or ethnic. You understand? It can be professionals coming together for an interest. So then we have conditions. When you say legal conditions, those are different. That is, what do they need to do this registration? First of all, they must have a name in mind. And that name will be verified, whether it is available or someone else has registered it, or there is another name that is too close to us to be mistaken for it. So we have that condition first. Then they will do a publication, as you have earlier said, so that the world will know that this organization has applied for registration, and that there is no objection from anybody. Either the objection may be because the name is similar to my own, or that we already are in this same kind of association together, so this is a breakaway and is going to cause confusion and so on, or so many other things, or that one of the trustees is not somebody that is of integrity.
I'm Magdalene Palmer.
My name is Toyin Yumesiri. I'm based in the U.S.
I'm Ken from Ken, Italy.
Keep watching Export Digest.
And I would recommend very strongly that you come along.
Keep watching Export Digest.
That is how we conclude this episode of Export Digest. We hope the program has helped in improving your knowledge of the non-oil export business environment in Nigeria. Thank you for joining us today. You can watch this particular episode and others before it on our YouTube channel, www.youtube.com/exportdigest. Do send in your comments, observations and contributions as we continue in our march towards making Nigeria a viable exporting nation and to lead our viewers into profitable export businesses. Our channels of communication are open and now showing on your screen. oil exports remains Nigeria's alternative source of foreign exchange, you also can be a big player by knowing how and what it takes to engage in profitable non-oil export business. Exports Digest features experts with local and global knowledge of non-oil export business, presenting you with everything you ever need to know. Non-oil items you can export, important tips on export packaging, export documentation and regulatory standards, logistics and transportation issues from farm gate to the port and then destination country, export funding and available markets for different commodities, products and services. Don't miss Export Digest, showing on Core TV Mondays at 8 p.m. with a repeat broadcast Wednesdays at 12:30 p.m. Export Digest, promoting Nigeria's non-oil export sector. Many thanks to our sponsors for their support. You also can advertise your products and services on Export Digest. Contact us and we will grow your business with you. Join us on this channel same time next week for another bumper package of Export Digest. My name is Mayoku Apoterabo. God bless you and God bless Nigeria.